And that's the biggest sham. With me in the studio, Yajuvinder Singh, former Indian cricketer. He's been chairman of cricket selection in Maharashtra. Borya Majumdar, following the story from Kolkata. Harinder Singh, former India hockey coach, Dronacharya awardee. And he has strong views on this. And I said earlier today I would get you in because I think every cricket lover is involved. And cricket lovers are not just those who play cricket, but those who follow cricket. I think every sports person now needs to come out and speak. From studios there in London, interestingly, both gentlemen have their arms crossed. I don't know whether it is because they are crossed or whether it's chilly in London. Sohail Seth and Mihir Bose. No, you don't have to change the body language. You're not on the defensive. The BCCI should be. Nilay Datta is member of the Legal and Finance Committee of the BCCI
from Guwahati. It's rather cold. It's rather unusually cold here, Arnab.
I tell you, it's rather unusually hot here. And it's getting hotter by the day. We thought things would cool down in Chennai. But I tell you, things are going to get hotter after this. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you for joining. Mihirda, why don't I open up by going to both the gentlemen in London out there. What do you make of this cosmetic sham, this power sharing agreement, you know, this neither here, neither there kind of solution that the BCCI has come out with in Chennai?
Well, listening to Mr. Jagmohan Dalmia, I'm absolutely appalled. This is the acting chairman, president of BCCI. He's returning to a position he held, and he seems to have no views.
No views.
He's sitting in the classical fence, and it seems the fence doesn't hurt him at all. I don't know what point of the fence he's sitting. He says, I don't have any views. He says the working committee has taken a decision. Well, can't he comment on what the working committee has done? Does he have no personal views on this scandal? I mean, this is the biggest scandal as one that hit the world cricket when he was president of the ICC, and he seems to have learned nothing from it in the last 15 years. He's like the French Bourbons. He's never learned anything, never understood anything. Cricket is at the end of the day a moral game.
No, so and then why has he been brought in? Some people felt that if you get Dalmia in, if you get Shashank Manohar in, the power lobby will come in. That's the problem. You know, everybody looked at this eventually in terms of lobbies.
No, but whoever
power lobby, power lobby, BJP lobby, Congress lobby, fans
should,
be damned.
What you should look at, Arnab, what you should look at is where does cricket stand? At the end of the day, a sport has to be not only clean, but has to appear to be clean and has to be run by officials who know what they have to administer the sport for and what sort of justice system.
No, of course it is.
That is not
of
being
course.
Shown at all.
Of and course, Sohail said. No, of course. You see,
Indian,
I never.
Indian cricket
I never gave.
Light.
I never gave any importance, Sohail, to semantics. But now today I must give a lot of emphasis on semantics because there is a world of difference between stepping aside and stepping down.
Indian cricket is not a puddle which Srinivasan had to step aside from. He had to step down if he had any morality, if he had any courage, if he had any shame. The fact that he didn't have these three was evident in the last 12, 13 days. So any of us who were expecting a lot from Srinivasan were being stupid. What we were seriously expecting was that some of those wise men, other than Srinivasan, who I would have imagined would have the interests of cricket, cricket fans, cricket lovers, at the core of their heart, let down an entire nation in addition to being shamed themselves. This is not going to go away. You replace one dolt with another. The tragedy is Jagmohan Dalmia, as Mehta has rightly said, Jagmohan Dalmia was as rooted in dictatorial behavior as Srinivasan is. So what have you done? We didn't expect a deck of cards to be shuffled.
That's
we expected
well said.
The deck of cards
well said.
To be dismantled and a new house to be built.
Well
that
said.
Is what we wanted. We
yeah, yeah.
did not want, we haven't put those men in positions of power, as you rightly said, at the beginning of the program,
yeah.
so that they could hoodwink us. Because if they think we are stupid, they're even stupider. The whole nation has seen through this, charade. So here's what's going to happen. Srinivasan will use Jagmohan Dalmia, and you're absolutely right. The war is not... See, Bernard Shaw rightly said, when whales fight, shrimps are eaten. The whales are Jagmohan Dalmia, Oblique Srinivasan, and Sharad Pawar. They are fighting. The shrimps don't know where to hide.
The tragedy is
that Srinivasan will now, through proxy, ensure that every investigation into his victoriously gallant son-in-law is scuttled. That is what you're going to see.
And that probe
cricket,
will have that
in terms
probe.
Of perceptual mapping has taken a huge hit.
That probe.
And we have now. We can now.
They don't care about perception.
Sohail,
do you think
in India?
Do you think they care about perception? You think they care about perception? To come out helplessly like that?
They will have to
avoid the cameras.
I tell you why.
No. What do you mean? They don't care about perception.
Everyone.
But the perception they will have to care about, Sohail.
Jagmohan knows money.
The perception they'll have to care about is whether that investigation has any credibility.
Know more about Arnob. Both these gentlemen love money. They love power more than they love the sport. You know why they will start worrying? When sponsors begin to withdraw. They will start worrying when government starts making a little bit of a noise.
Yeah.
They will start worrying when they see the cash machines dry up. That's when they will start worrying.
And I'm asking.
But the problem there is, going by the example of FIFA, the sponsors are themselves not morally accountable and they don't do anything.
No. Credibility matters, Mehirda.
This is where the Indian public comes in.
Mehirda.
The Indian public must say, we are not going to use these products.
We are not going to
drink Pepsi or Coke or whoever the sponsors
Pepsi,
are.
Pepsi.
We are not going to travel on Sahara. You know, unless the Indian public now respond in this big way and hit the pockets, we are not going to see any change.
Well, you know, I tell you something. Credibility does matter. And however much anybody may say a brand is built through credibility, before I go to Nila Datta, and these are opening comments on the News Hour tonight. Gentlemen, we have a lot of time. We're going to debate this through and through. I'd like to go across to Yajuvinder Singh, former Indian cricketer, and he's been in administrative positions in my studio in Mumbai. Nila Datta, I'll come to you after that. You know, the question very much is this. This investigation, does it have any credibility if Srinivasan continues to be BCCI boss? It doesn't matter whether he doesn't do day to day. I mean, what do you mean by day to day? He won't sign the papers. He won't sign 2,000 rupee bills. He won't sign taxi bills. Will that investigation have any credibility, Mr. Yajuvinder Singh, with Srinivasan still there as the boss?
See, this was a good time for BCCI to actually come out as a transparent, open and aggressive institution, basically.
Yes.
And what happened with it, and it seemed like that everyone around, at least most of those working committee members and so many of those members.
Yes.
They were all aggressive and they were coming out very
Where
much.
Were they aggressive?
They were coming out that they are going to come out with something different.
They raised
time.
Hopes, Mr. Yajuvinder Singh. Where were they aggressive, actually? They raised hopes. Mr. Arun Jaitley said that we will expect something
so
significant.
So they did raise hope. So that's what I'm saying. That's what exactly they put us to a stage where we were going to get something out of it. And what happened next was... nothing happened after this.
Well, was this asking for too much to ask for his sacking? Was that asking for too much in your view?
You know, when you look at it, just think there are only two people who are really involved in cricket who we should sort of respect. One is the spectators, followers and fans.
Yeah, yeah.
And the other is the cricketer.
Yeah.
And in this case, the spectators and the fans are asking questions. And in today's world, I mean, where you have... all the social media and your mediums, everything happens quickly. No. By the way, you know, I'd like to tell you, Wikipedia has already got Dalmia as interim president of the BCCI.
Well, so good for Dalmia.
Yeah,
good for Dalmia. I just say that, you know, when we started reporting this story, I don't think, with greatest of respect, Nilay Datta, let me come to you next.
Yep.
Nobody would have said, so such a big scam in cricket, what's the solution? Get in Jagmohan Dalmia. Was this all about getting Jagmohan Dalmia, Nilay Datta? Will you, as a member of the Legal and Finance Committee of the BCCI, say that the people of this country should be very happy because Jagu Dada is back? Was this about getting Jagmohan Dalmia? Or was this about cleaning up the mess? Was it about conflict of interest? Was it about Srinivasan and Gurunath Maiyappan and fixing and betting and dubious things happening in the world of cricket? Was it about that or was it about getting back Jagmohan Dalmia? Nilay Datta.
Let me make this very clear. In the recent days, cricket has taken a beating. BCCI has taken a beating. We have to go into the fundamentals of the problem. It's a matter of fixing. It's a matter of betting. And to get into the main problem, we have to thank Delhi police and the Mumbai police, who have done a wonderful job till date to go into the root of the problem, and I'm sure that they will come up with solutions to the problem, at least in so far as the punishment is concerned. That brings us to the question of what the BCCI should do. Now, to find out problems of betting and fixing, BCCI must remain united and cannot be a divided house.
No, what do you mean by united? United for what?
We have to come up with a working solution to the problem which was besetting us.
No, united
now
for what?
We have a working solution
today. No, unity is
and
good.
I would say
unity
solution.
Is good. But, you know, I'm sorry to say the BCCI is not the Republic of India whose unity we should celebrate. Unity for what? Unity for a cover-up? Unity to keep Srinivasan up there?
Unity to do an internal investigation?
Unity to tell a billion
just
people that we will sit in Chennai and decide what to do, Mr. Niladatta.
That
unity is destructive for cricket. It's destructive for the game, Mr. Niladatta.
That unity was important for the simple reason.
What unity?
That unless. What was the fundamental?
Who cares about this?
We have to have a commission of inquiry.
Mr. Datta, with the greatest of respect, sir.
Mr. Datta, you're a very senior man.
You're a very senior man. And I must ask. Mr. Datta. I have great respect
for
you, but unity
speaking,
for what? What unity?
I'm coming to it.
Tomorrow will people say, let's get Lalit Modi back from London. Let's be even more united.
Lalit Modi right now is not allowed to come in because of the simple reason that he's a fugitive from law.
Sir, Mr. Niladatta, I am not
surrender to the law,
Mr. Datta,
and let him sort out his
Mr. Datta, I, as a cricket lover or a journalist, I am not interested at all in your factional fights. I am not interested whether you break up, whether you are united.
I have an audio problem here. I can't hear you.
No. Can you hear me?
Arnab, can I please make my initial comment?
Sorry.
One sec. Boria wants to respond. Wow. Boria, yes. Boria wants to respond to that. Boria.
No. You gave everybody an opportunity to make my initial comments, their initial comments. So can I just make my quick three points?
Others also haven't, but yes, please do.
They haven't done that.
Not everyone has, yes.
Okay. One. Okay, I'm sure everybody will. One, if you just take one simple fact, the fact is anyone in this country buying the theory, step aside means resignation? Not a single cricket fan is buying. So basically 1 billion people have been kicked in the gut. Point number two, we expect at the end of a day like this, a responsible body to at least hold a press conference to answer some serious questions
that
journalists
will
pose.
Good
and
point.
We will want some answers. Was there a press conference? No, not at all.
One press release, a four-line press
media.
Release.
Final point. Hold on. Final point. Question number three. Last 3 days, sporadically, several leaders were coming out and giving individual bites, raising hopes. Can you please tell me why these leaders are not sitting together in a panel in any television channel, maybe not on Times Now, and or in a public platform?
Because,
and answering 25
because Boria, and I will risk answering that question. In the morning I said you ask awkward questions. It's good to ask awkward questions. That's a straight question. You know why they are not coming out? Because they know what they have done is not right. Because they know that what they have done will not wash with the people of India. Because they know that this is nothing but coterie management. They know that they have let down sports lovers. And one of those sports lovers who called me today and SMS'd me and said, I want to speak out on this, is with us now on the show, is Harendra Singh, Dronacharya Award winner and former India hockey coach. Harendra Singh, I was really moved by what you said earlier today and how you felt at what was going on in Chennai. I'd like you to say that once again today. What do you feel? As one of India's greatest sports legends, what do you feel about what the BCCI has done?
Arnab, first of all, I'd like to thank you because last 15 days I really struggling myself to come out, but all this, what the mockery is happening in Indian sports. Today is the mockery of Indian sports the BCCI has done. If anybody want to learn how to fix the match, is the BCCI has show the way of the all the sports federation. Everybody is coming out and saying, okay, the BCCI should come out, clean this thing. It's really ridiculous about all the 22 members who are present over there.